On March 14th, SpaceX celebrated its 20th birthday. Being one of the most powerful rocket companies, SpaceX has single-handedly changed the aerospace industry. It's the only commercial company in the world that has the technology to launch reusable rockets. However, the company's development hasn't always been this successful. Since its establishment in 2002, SpaceX rockets have had its fair share of failures. Its first three rocket explosions almost led the company to bankruptcy. So how did SpaceX get from muddy waters to the world's most renowned rocket company over the past 20 years? In today's video, we'll explore the founding story of SpaceX. It's more compelling than you think. SpaceX's success is built on its rockets, Falcon 1, Falcon 9, Dragon, and Starship. The first rocket that SpaceX designed and built was Falcon 1. If SpaceX was a castle, then Falcon 1 would be its cornerstone. It's their very first attempt at a reusable rocket. It was a small, simple rocket that was designed for low Earth orbit flights. The development of Falcon 1 started in early 2002, but it didn't really go well. Out of the five launches, three ended in explosions. Despite its setbacks, SpaceX continued working on the Falcon 1 until it finally had a successful launch with the 165-kilogram dummy payload in 2008. The following year, at its fifth and last launch, Falcon 1 successfully carried the Malaysian satellite into space and managed to complete five launches before it was retired in 2009. It paved the way for a low-cost commercial rocket launch system for the company. Even though Falcon 1's success gained a lot of interest from other companies, SpaceX's goal was to create rockets with more carrying capacity. And for this reason, they developed a new and improved version of the Falcon 1, named Falcon 9. Its name jumped directly from number 1 to number 9 because Falcon 9 was equipped with 9 engines instead of 1. And thanks to its 9 engines, Falcon 9 can carry a payload weighing up to 13,150 kilograms into low Earth orbit. However, as the number of launches gradually increased, so did its launch costs. So in an effort to significantly reduce costs, SpaceX began to develop the first stage of a reusable rocket. In 2003, they achieved a huge milestone in the space industry. For the first time in history, a private company launched and then landed a rocket back on Earth. The whole event was caught on camera and watched by millions around the world. This was a major turning point for SpaceX because it demonstrated that their technology worked and that it was possible to reuse a rocket. Following the success, SpaceX continued to develop its rockets with the ultimate goal of making them fully reusable. So in 2018, they made another big step forward when they successfully launched and landed a used Falcon 9 rocket. This meant that SpaceX could now launch, land, and then relaunch a rocket within 24 hours. After proving the possibilities of reusable rockets, SpaceX later developed a heavy-duty version of the Falcon rockets named the Falcon Heavy. Falcon Heavy is the world's most powerful rocket, which even sent a Tesla car into space. This also made SpaceX the first private company to launch objects into heliocentric orbit. In addition to sending satellites to space, the company also wanted to send astronauts to space. For this reason, they developed the Dragon spacecraft. Dragon is a reusable spacecraft designed to transport astronauts and cargo to and from the International Space Station. It featured a white, minimalistic design with flat panel displays and four windows for passengers to see outside. And in May 2020, SpaceX successfully sent two NASA astronauts to the ISS, making it the first commercial company in history to carry out crewed space mission. SpaceX's ultimate goal is to send humans to Mars and establish a colony there. To achieve this, they are currently developing a new spacecraft called Starship. Starship is a reusable spacecraft that is being designed to transport large numbers of people and cargoes to Mars. It will be the largest and most powerful spacecraft ever built and will be powered by SpaceX Raptor engines. The first prototype of Starship was unveiled by Elon Musk in September 2019 and is currently undergoing test flights. If all goes well, SpaceX plans to launch its first Mars mission by 2024. As for today, SpaceX has come a long way since it was founded in 2002. It has designed, built, and launched some of the most advanced rockets. In the commercial spacecraft industry, SpaceX can be seen as second to none. So the question now is, how did SpaceX do it? To know how, we first have to talk about the person in the center of it all, Elon Musk. In 2001, the 30-year-old entrepreneur just sold his second company, X.com. It was an online financial service for easy money transfers. And after it merged with Confinity and officially rebranded to PayPal, Elon was forced to leave the company after disagreements with the board of directors. But that didn't bother Elon Musk that much, as he already had another startup idea. This time, he turned his focus from the internet to space. He believed that humans should establish a colony on other planets aside from Earth. So in the same year, Elon introduced Project Mars Oasis, which is the code for a project that would build small greenhouses on Mars for cultivation. For this reason, SpaceX was born in California warehouse in 2002. However, when it first started out, conditions weren't exactly the most ideal. At its lowest point, SpaceX and Tesla faced bankruptcy at the same time. Even though Elon was left with a sufficient amount of wealth after he sold X.com, it was unsubstantial to the amount needed to fund an aerospace company. And because the private aerospace industry is practically a money burner, and no one had ever made it work as a commercial aerospace company, Elon had a hard time gathering investors. As a result, he ended up taking $100 million out of his own pocket to invest in his own company. He initially tried to buy refurbished Russian ballistic missiles, but had to scrap that idea because it was too expensive. After a couple of trips back from Russia, he had an idea. Why not build cheaper rockets of his own? So for the next few months, he turned to books to find cheaper alternatives, and his biggest takeaway was that the price of raw material to produce rocket was only about 3% of its market price, which means, from a physics standpoint, building a low-cost rocket is possible. In addition, Elon Musk believed that rockets should be reusable. If made possible, it could reduce launch costs by 90%. In addition, if Musk could produce 85% of his own parts and software modules in-house, it could potentially make launching rockets a sustainable business with a 70% gross margin. But even with this plan and vision, the process of making it happen is full of uncertainty. And even Elon himself thought that it was 90% chance they could lose everything. The reason he thought the chances were bleak were later proved to be true when SpaceX failed 3 launch attempts of its first rocket, Falcon 1. On March 24, 2006, Falcon 1 caught on fire and crashed just 25 seconds after launch. On March 15, 2007, Falcon 1 lost control, disintegrated, and finally exploded 5 minutes after liftoff. On August 2, 2008, Falcon 1 collided as the rocket separated after liftoff, and the rocket finally crashed before entering orbit. These attempts burned through almost all of the company's capital and caused a public relations crisis. No investor or bank would want to trust a private company that specialized in failed launches. SpaceX was on the verge of bankruptcy. So to keep the company afloat, Elon sold his sports car along with other personal assets and borrowed money from his friends and family. Given the circumstances, many of Elon's friends urged him to shut down SpaceX to be able to focus on Tesla. And in one interview, a reporter even asked him, "Have you ever thought about packing this in after third failed launch?" Never. Elon shook his head and answered without hesitation. Fortunately, Elon Musk was able to find enough money to afford one more launch, and potentially the last one too. As he put all of SpaceX's remaining egg in one basket, the company's fourth launch attempt was on September 28, 2008. It was successful, so on September 28, 2008, SpaceX attempted its fourth launch. And this time, Falcon 1 soared to the sky. It was the first liquid-fueled rocket developed by a private company to achieve orbit in history. And it solved the company's financial problems almost immediately. At the end of the same year, NASA handed over a commercial contract worth about $1.6 billion to SpaceX, and SpaceX officially started its road to reinventing the world. One of its most notable achievements is the Falcon 9 mentioned earlier, which is a partially reusable two-stage medium-sized launch vehicle. The Falcon 9 retails a proper amount of fuel in advance, so it takes pressure off the airframe. And at the same time, it also allows the rocket's engine to reignite, and then rely on a precise control system to land smoothly. The concept completely dismissed the traditional mechanism of using an aerodynamic lift to return the rocket. It directly allows the rocket to return by using its own power, which is an amazing technological innovation. It's the only reusable launch rocket in the world, and since then, Falcon 9 has launched a total of 147 times. Last year, Elon Musk revealed his Mars immigration plan, which details how he plans to send 1 million people to reside on Mars by 2050. He laid out a plan to build 1,000 starships over the span of 10 years, meaning that he has to build 100 ships a year that can carry close to 100 million tons of supply. This will rely on building a rocket that is capable of successfully carrying heavy supply and people up to Mars. Elon dubbed this the Big Falcon Rocket, or the Big Falcon Rocket, as Musk has hinted, which will integrate all of the features from Falcon 9, Falcon Heavy, and Dragon mentioned earlier today. Who knows if this is going to become a reality, but at least for now, happy 20th anniversary to SpaceX. Thanks for watching Money Therapy, a channel about money. see you in the next one.